I wasn't ready.
I have no arms and no legs, but I'm very thankful that I have my little chicken drumstick here. People freak out when they see me for the first time. It's so cool. I was at a water slide all by myself. Everyone obviously at the bottom of the slide is looking up and waiting for other people to come down. And here I come and they're freaking out. They're like, you know, like this. And I was so tempted to look at myself and go, what happened? You know? And there were times where I sort of looked at my life and thinking, well, I can't do this and I can't do that. And you keep on concentrating on the things that you wish you had or the things that you wish you didn't have. And you sort of forget what you do have. And there's no point, I believe, in my life where I wish I had arms and legs, I wish I had arms and legs, I wish I had arms and legs, because wishing won't help. But what I've seen in life are just a couple key principles, and the first thing that I've seen is to be thankful. It's hard to be thankful, man. I tell you, when I was 8 years old, I sort of summed up my life and thought, I'm never going to get married, I'm not going to have a job, I'm not going to have a life of purpose. What kind of a husband am I going to be if I can't even hold my wife's hand? It's a lie to think that you're not good enough. It's a lie to think that you're not worth anything.
So it's like... You like that? That would be really cool if I could get this and get some techno going, like, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go, you like that? Is that cool? Beautiful. But honestly, along the way, you might fall down like this. Ready?
Hello!
So what do you do when you fall down? Get back up. Everybody knows to get back up, because if I start walking, I'm not going to get anywhere. But I tell you, there are some times in life where you fall down and you feel like you don't have the strength to get back up. Do you think you have hope? Because I tell you, I'm down here, face down, and I have no arms, no legs. It should be impossible for me to get back up, but it's not. You see, I will try 100 times to get up, and if I fail 100 times, if I fail and I give up, do you think that I'm ever going to get up? No. But if I fail, I try again and again and again. But I just want you to know that it's not the end. It matters how you're going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? And you will find that strength to get back up like this.
I love life. You know, so many people come and say, how come you smile so much? And I'm like, well, it's a long story. But it's very simple at the same time. You see, it's very hard to smile sometimes in life. There are things that happen that you don't know and you don't understand, and you don't know if you're going to get through it. You know, you go through your storms in life and you don't know how long this storm's going to be. And today I want to share with you some principles that I've learned in my life that you can use in yours. Being patient is beautiful, and I tell you, it's the hardest thing. But I realize I may not have hands to hold my wife's hand, but when the time comes, I'll be able to hold her heart. I don't need hands to hold her heart.
You know, it is scary to know how many girls have eating disorders. It is scary to know how many people are just angry at life because of their situation at home and anger at others. It's scary to know how many people actually feel like they're worth nothing. Every single girl right here, right now, I want you to know that you are beautiful. You are gorgeous just the way you are. And you boys,
you're the man.
On this DVD, I share my experiences in life of how I've overcome challenges and seen a new, fresh perspective in life. To be thankful, to dream big, and to never give up. I speak to children, youth, and adults about key issues and principles that I've applied in my life that has given me the strength to conquer all that comes before me.